My research focuses on an area known as nanomedicine, and that's really designing small molecules or small particles that are able to deliver drugs in a more effective means or effective manner. More recently, I've pushed towards radiopharmaceuticals, which is utilizing radiation as really highly potent drug or therapy to treat many different diseases, but in particular cancer. We have biologists, chemists, materials scientists, radiochemists, radiobiologists. Really what we try to do is understand the big picture of delivering therapies, and we do that through molecular imaging. And molecular imaging is a field that allows us to use really high sensitivity and high resolution images in living subjects to better understand how to treat diseases. Some of the biggest breakthroughs in targeted therapies or therapies to treat in particular oncology have come in recently in the field of radiopharmaceutics, and radiopharmaceutics really is an emerging field. There's so much research that needs to be done to understand how these radiopharmaceuticals behave, and more importantly, to design new radiopharmaceuticals that are more efficient, more effective at treating disease and targeting the disease cells rather than having effects elsewhere in the body. So one thing that really got me excited in our team in the last few years was development of these new devices in our lab that allowed us to precisely understand how much therapeutic was being delivered to different parts of a subject. And so what we developed in the team was a way to understand when you take an image of your patient, in every single voxel within that image, we could understand how much drug was being released or chemotherapeutic drug was being released. What it meant for downstream development of therapeutics was that we could tell how much drug was going to tissues that you didn't want it to go to, so off-target accumulation of your drug, and how much drug was actually going into the disease tissue, which is where we really want that high impact of the drug delivery. So a large part of our research is interacting directly with industry and commercial partners, and we work with multiple biotech companies in Australia and also abroad, and we're developing ways to not only improve their materials or their therapeutics, but also to give them more mechanistic understanding of how they work. We have at AIBN and at UQ probably one of the most comprehensive suites for developing a pipeline for translation of radiopharmaceutics, all the way from discovery and innovation through to testing and validation and then ultimately manufacture of these materials.